Hi everyone, welcome to this video on getting started with the Syncfusion Flutter event calendar. In this video, you will see how to add the Syncfusion Flutter event calendar widget to a Flutter project. You will learn how to change the calendar view and the first day of the week, and how to set the initial display date. You will also see how to set the initial selected date of the calendar and schedule appointments, that is, events. Finally, I will show you how to create a recurring appointment and an all-day appointment. First, open the VS Code Editor. You can also use one of the preferred IDEs, such as Android Studio or IntelliJ. This computer was already set up with the Flutter development environment, so I can directly create a new Flutter project. Open the command palette and create a new Flutter project. Choose a folder to create the project within. Name the project My Flutter App. VS Code creates the Flutter project for you. First, run this application. Choose the Android simulator. You can also use the terminal to run the project. You can see the application with a button widget at the bottom and a text widget at the center. When you click the button, the click count is updated in the text widget. Now, let's see how to add a calendar widget in this app, instead of the text and button widgets. To do so, first, import the Syncfusion Flutter calendar package from the pub.dev. Open the pub/spec.yaml file. Declare the dependency, Syncfusion_Flutter_calendar, using the latest version. When you save the file, the package is downloaded. The download is completed now. Next, open the main.dart file. Import the calendar.dart library so that you can use the calendar widget in this file. Write the code within the My Homepage State class. Remove the existing code for better clarity. Override the build method. Within the build method, return a scaffold widget so that you can set the SF calendar widget to its body. Set the SF calendar widget as a body of the scaffold widget. Then, save the file. The hot reload injects the new version of this file to the application in the Android emulator. You can see the Syncfusion Flutter calendar rendered with the default day view added to the application. You can change the calendar view. Calendar supports day view, which is the default view, week view, work week, month, and timeline day, timeline week, timeline work week, and timeline month. Now, let me change the day view to the month view. In the SF calendar, set the view property with the value calendar view.month. Save the file now. You can see that the calendar view has been changed to the month view. Next, change the view to week. Save the file, and the calendar view changes to week view. Next, let me show you how to change the first day of the week. In countries like the USA and Japan, the first day of the week is Sunday, while in the Middle East, the week begins with Saturday. Considering this use case, the event calendar allows you to change the first day of the week. To do that, in the SF calendar, use the property first day off week and set the value to 6, which means Saturday. You can set the value starting from 0, which is Sunday, to 6, which is Saturday. When you save the file, notice that Saturday is displayed as the first day of the week. Now, let me change the display date of the calendar at the initial load. By default, the current date is displayed as the initial display date. To customize the initial display date, use the initial display date property and set the value date time, 1st of March, 8:30 a.m. Save the file. As you can see, the week view displays the 1st of March. Since the view property is set to week and the first day is set to Saturday, the week view displays the provided initial display date based on all these property settings. Now, to set the 1st of March as the selected date, use the initial selected date property and set the value. I copy and paste the same datetime value here. Save the file to see the new changes. You can see the 1st of March is selected. Next, let's add an appointment to this calendar. Consider you have a use case to schedule an event today at 9 a.m. To achieve this programmatically, I first comment out the property's initial display date and initial selected date, as they are out of this scope. To display the scheduled appointments on the calendar, set the value for the data source property of the calendar widget. The calendar widget has the built-in capability to handle appointments internally, based on the provided appointment collection. Now, we'll display the appointments using the built-in appointment class. The built-in appointment class contains all the required fields for an event creation. Each event should have the mandatory fields, start time and end time, and you need to define them. First, I need to define a class to generate a data source for my calendar. To do so, I define a class meeting data source that extends the calendar data source abstract class. This calendar data source abstract class provides the blueprint for the calendar data source. Also, you can easily customize the implementations such as the start time and end time, and many more, if you have your own data model class. I will explain data source binding using business objects in my upcoming videos. Now, define a constructor and receive the parameter of type list of appointment source. Within it, set the appointments object, which is declared in the calendar data source class, with the parameter value source. Next, let me create one appointment for today's date and set it to the calendar's data source property. Define a method that returns the list of appointment, getAppointments. Within it, declare a variable of type list of appointment meetings and initialize it with an empty array. Declare a dateTime variable today and set the value to dateTime.now. Declare another variable of type dateTime for the start time and set the value dateTime to today.year, today.month, today.day, and pass the hour as 9, the minute as 0, and the second as 0. Declare another dateTime variable for the endTime and set the value startTime.add, duration of hours. Set the value to 2 so that the appointment starts at 9 a.m. and ends after 2 hours at 11 a.m. Next, add a new appointment object to the meetings collection. Set the event start time and end time. As I said before, these two fields are mandatory for an event. Set the name to conference and the color to blue. Finally, return the meetings collection object. Now, in the calendar, set the data source property with a meeting data source object by passing the getAppointments method, which will return one appointment object. Save the file to view the event in the calendar. Here, you can see the appointment added to today's date for 2 hours from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. as set. Next, let me show you how to set this appointment to recur for the next 10 days. In the getAppointments method, set the recurrence rule property to the appointment object, with a string value freq equal to daily and count equal to 10. Then, the conference appointment will be repeated for the next 10 days. Save the file. You can see the appointment scheduled for the next 10 days. This repeat icon indicates that this appointment is a recurring appointment. You can assign values to the recurrence rule based on the R rule that defines a repeating pattern in the string format for recurring events. These are the properties used in the R rule. FREQ, this maintains the repeat type value of the appointment. For example, daily, weekly, monthly, yearly, every weekday. You can also provide properties such as interval, count, until, by month, and by set POS. Now, let's see how to set this appointment for the whole day. In the getAppointments method, set the isAllDay to true in the appointment object, so that the appointment is set for the whole day. Save the file, and you can see the appointment set for a whole day at the top. That's it. Let me summarize the main points. You saw how to add the Sync Fusion Flutter event calendar widget to a Flutter project. You learned how to change the calendar view and the first day of the week, and how to set the initial display date. You also learned how to set an initial selected date in the calendar, and how to schedule appointments. Finally, I explained how to create a recurring appointment and an all-day appointment. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the video description below. You can also check if you are eligible for our community license, which gives you a free license key to use our Flutter products. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching.